It's hard to find a better description of TIS-100 than the tagline Zachtronics came up with themselves. They describe it as the assembly language programming game you never asked for. Start it up and after a short, fake boot screen, you'll be dumped directly into the level select menu with no explanation. Click into the first segment and you'll be greeted by a bunch of empty squares. You might not realize it, but at this point you're already playing the game. To talk about TIS, I have to first talk about the several page long reference booklet which comes bundled with it. This is what you get instead of a tutorial, and how much you'll enjoy your time with the game will largely depend on whether you think this sounds like a great idea or a terrible one. This risky concept instantly hooked me, partly because games have become increasingly patronizing as they shifted away from manuals and instead relied on in-game tutorials. To Zachtronics' credit, InfiniFactory managed to effectively tutorialize without being condescending, but still, seeing a return to this upfront approach was refreshing. In a funny way, this is actually kind of similar to Spacechem's setup. It relies on the player opening an outside file, although a PDF seems like a lesser evil than an online video, and it explains concepts before you've had a chance to try them firsthand. The details make all the difference though. With TIS, the manual is one of the game's hooks and you're encouraged to print it off, keeping a physical version of it on your desk as you play. In a sense, we might think of this as giving the player a second screen with useful information, it's just that the screen happens to be made of paper. This could easily be taken as lazy, and maybe to some degree it is, but it nicely imitates the sort of programming documentation you might find in real life. Printing it off, reading it, and referring back to it while tackling the first few problems is an incredibly novel experience. While Zachtronics' previous games tended to become more approachable over time, yes, even Spacechem is accessible compared to Cocktopus, TIS charges confidently in the opposite direction. It's intimidating, it's unfriendly, but that's part of the appeal. Using a manual instead of a tutorial might appear to be just a gimmick at first, but it has a wonderful effect on player progression. Every operation is unlocked right at the start, but you're unlikely to utilize them all from the get-go, and there are nuances which can be used for more efficient solutions. A good early example is the second problem. At first, you might double the value by passing it twice from one node to another, but actually you can just use the command addACC to double the accumulator. You could say this contrasts with the previous approach of new techniques unfolding from existing ones, but that distinction isn't quite so clear when you pay proper attention to the documentation. The add command doesn't explicitly list addACC as valid, but the first line about the instruction set states that the source and destination parameters may specify a port or internal register. Further down, addACC is used as part of an example program, so if you read the whole document and pay attention, you're rewarded. The important thing is that the manual never lies to you, it simply makes some pieces of information more obvious than others. At first, you might scratch your head at how JRO, any, or last could ever be useful, but sooner or later you'll see why they are. Late into the first campaign, I had an earth-shattering moment of realization about one command when I suddenly saw how many possibilities it opened up. If you've finished the game, you likely know which one I'm referring to. It might be hard to imagine, given how sterile the presentation is, but this moment made me burst into genuine excitement at having grasped a new concept. The funny thing is that the information had been there the entire time, I just hadn't put the pieces together yet. By not having any unlock system at all, TIS arguably has better progression than Spacechem or InfiniFactory because it moves at your pace and allows you the joy of discovering things almost entirely by yourself. Of course, this will be lost on some people who are unwilling to put in the effort, but you don't make a game about assembly programming if you're trying to please everyone. Since players are given all their tools up front, nothing can be saved for later, or so you'd think. Stack memory nodes and visualization modules cleverly get around this problem by building their gimmicks directly into individual puzzles. Naturally, this kind of variety is welcome, but it's also self-defeating in a way. Seeing these new features creates the expectation that more will follow, but they never do. Everything is introduced well before the second campaign even unlocks, which leads to some minor disappointment when that one fails to reveal any surprises. This is an area where Zachtronics have performed exceptionally well in the past, so it's an even bigger letdown with that context in mind, but at least by sticking to the essentials, they've totally sidestepped one of the principal issues with InfiniFactory, the ambiguous histograms. Although you won't be aware of certain functionality until you gain more experience, you're technically playing with the same tools as everyone else right from the outset. Some of the solutions are so varied that scores are lumped together into wide categories, which dampens the graph's usefulness, but it's easy to see why they wanted to keep the histogram simple so as to be consistent with the rest of the visuals. Optimization is also more immediately rewarding than InfiniFactory. Rather than having to tweak the speed beforehand, making a more efficient solution will automatically speed it up. This means you can often shave off a few cycles without having to rewrite your entire program. Capitalizing on the multi-core nature of the TIS for reduced cycle counts is the most appealing optimization metric, but the others have merit as well. Reducing the minimum number of nodes or lines an algorithm requires would be useful. It would allow a theoretical TIS to execute more tasks concurrently. The knowledge and techniques you gain by creating a more compact program can also come in handy for later puzzles, which often sprawl over several complex functions. In many ways, TIS combines the better parts of Zachtronics' previous games. The 2D layout means that all information is available on screen at once, and tweaks can be made relatively quickly. As you'd expect by now, there's custom puzzle creation and a sandbox which you can use for whatever lofty purposes you imagine. Some of the small improvements of InfiniFactory have been taken into account as well. Each stage has multiple save files, boss fights are still thankfully a thing of the past, progression is even more non-linear than before, and the story is presented in a manner that suits the style of game. While there are basically no moments like the ones in InfiniFactory where the story was sometimes furthered by the puzzles, TIS at least carves out its own style compared to Zachtronics' previous efforts. As a story, it's unlikely to get you emotionally invested in any way, but the obtuse presentation turns it into a sort of puzzle of its own, which obviously matches the genre. There is, however, one distinct area where TIS falls short of the other games, the visual feedback of seeing the puzzle solved. A large part of the satisfaction in Spacechem and InfiniFactory is watching your creation come to life once it's finally complete. Seeing the pieces automatically fall into place over and over again is reward enough for whatever hard work it might have taken to get there. Experiencing this just a handful of times might be enough to make you a Zachtronics junkie for life. Sadly, the TIS equivalent is usually just an array of numbers filling up the left side of the screen. The way currently executing statements are inverted makes the program itself look more lively, but there's only so much you can do to make a bunch of assembly code visually interesting. Conceptually, it's easy to see that clearing a level in TIS is something to be proud of. In true Zachtronics fashion, the later puzzles are some of the hardest you're ever likely to come across, harder than many tasks actual programmers face. There's enjoyment to be had solving real-world problems under harsh constraints, but the visuals are often just too abstract to really tickle the brain in the same way as those earlier games. Thankfully, there are some exceptions, the visualization challenges which, partway through, recapture much of that lost magic. The simple act of drawing a few pixels on a small grid is much more visually impressive than the alternatives. Of course, some of these will be more enjoyable than others. Image test patterns can have clever optimization strategies, but are otherwise relatively simplistic. On the other hand, the spatial path viewer presents a solid challenge with a gratifying payoff. Implementing a similar draw command every time does get repetitive, but it's a necessary evil since allowing for more than one output would significantly diminish the challenge. The way everything is funneled through a bottleneck means you have to get creative with how you store, process, and pass data about positions and colors. This inherent repetitiveness is slightly off-putting, but the visual reward makes them some of the most appealing puzzles to solve regardless. TIS clearly inherits from its predecessors, but it doesn't just blindly follow in their footsteps. Considering how different it is from the previous games, it's impressive how perfectly Zachtronics have nailed the implementation. Its unique premise is accounted for and capitalized on. It's important to recognize that the game isn't exactly like real-life assembly programming, nor is it trying to be. Despite its appearance and inherent difficulty for non-programmers, TIS arguably has to work harder to appeal to programmers more than anyone else. If you could already write assembly, and this game was just a perfect recreation of that, you'd have fewer reasons to play it. It would still have some value since it handles the more unenjoyable parts of development like setup, requirements, and testing, but to really be considered a worthwhile game, it needs to be more than just a series of assembly problems you could easily tackle for yourself. The way it provides that value is by imitating a transputer instead of a computer. On top of that, the instruction set is quite limited, the nodes all run perfectly synced with one another, and memory allocation is about as restrictive as possible. These quirks and constraints combine to provide an experience you can't get elsewhere, at least not to my knowledge anyway. The unique considerations don't stop there. Given how flexible the player's tools are, it would be easy to fabricate the required outputs on many challenges. Forcing the program to run four separate tests, one of them being randomly generated, ensures that the solution must be proper, not custom-made for the inputs at hand. Thankfully, the random test is also excluded from scores, making scoring consistent for each attempt. The final score is also determined by the worst case in order to disincentivize players from building a state machine which cheats a single test, then does the rest of them properly. Technically, you can still use this technique to improve your current worst case, but the reward is a lot smaller than it would be otherwise. Not only is the scoring well implemented, but so are the test values themselves. Usually, each level will present edge cases in the first round of inputs, so you can see any gotchas coming well ahead of time. On the other hand, it's also impossible to view what the second and third test will be until later, encouraging players to anticipate potential issues and build robust solutions with those in mind. The secret puzzle, which obfuscates the objective, is an interesting twist which wouldn't have made sense in Spacechem or InfiniFactory since the outputs were purely visual and never changed anyway. Any fan of Zachtronics other games should also be particularly amused by building their very own histogram viewer. Even the simplistic graphics are perfectly suited to the premise, allowing players to pretend that they really are working on some mysterious, outdated hardware. Unfortunately, this illusion is incomplete because some menus can only be navigated by mouse, even though a TIS probably wouldn't have had one. The cursor itself also seems a bit too small and sharp compared to everything else. Still, it's noteworthy that while many games simply use keyboards because computers are expected to have them, a keyboard is the perfect input device for a game centered around typing. After the surprisingly great soundtracks of both Spacechem and InfiniFactory, I have to admit I was initially a little disappointed that there was no music to be found in TIS. There are some satisfying clacks and bleeps to be heard along the way, but for the most part it's a silent experience. As with many of the design decisions, this too eventually clicked into place for me. I took it as an invitation to play my own music, something I would only rarely do while playing games, but often engage in while programming. Counterintuitively, this makes the game more immersive, not less. If a TIS really did exist and I really was debugging one, I probably would have some music on in the background. It's a rare and interesting quality, just another in the long list of virtues this game has going for it. TIS is a fantastic example of how games can be fun and even a bit educational at the same time. Playing any of Zachtronics' problem-solving games would almost certainly exercise your critical thinking skills, but TIS also demystifies assembly programming, even if it's not a perfectly accurate representation of it. Assembly is the kind of black art that even many programmers feel intimidated by, so to take that as a subject and turn it into a game, much less an enjoyable one, is quite an incredible feat. The minimalist styling is unique and enhances the experience, the core concepts are well fleshed out and result in rewarding problems to solve. It may not be ambitious, particularly for a developer with so much experience in the genre, but it's the purest iteration on the idea to date. Maybe it shouldn't come as a surprise that a game about writing code is itself a well-written piece of software. Like any good program, it sticks to its goals and accomplishes everything it sets out to do. In the next video, Wo Menjen Zai Ban Dao Shen Jen. So I hope you'll join me then. Thanks for watching.